Check, check, check. Yes, it is, Busan Misan. Thank you for asking. Hello and welcome. There's nothing really to say today. I'm just going to jump right in. You gotta love mixed bus for the ease of and the smoothness of those transitions that were super easy. I couldn't hear it. Granted, it's not a hard thing to crossfade, but yeah, just no trace of it. It's completely seamless. I love it. You've convinced me, mixed bus. I'm in. Pesky horn is gone. Without a trace. I'm just going to listen to this recording of Ice and Wind in Iceland that I found under Creative Commons license. And see what parts of it are best to use. I don't want to use the whole thing. It's obvious I don't know where that big rush is coming from. It's pretty embarrassing. I don't even know where my own sounds are coming from. It's a mystery. Wrapped in an enigma. Can it be? Oh, I got it. This is a mixed bus. The mixed bus is not limiting. Threshold. Why aren't you thresholding? Sounds better. Not completely, but that sounds better. And then we return from the land of the inside of our mind to the outside of the harsh reality of wind and rain in Finland. Although, not Finland, Iceland, which is not exactly Denmark, but close enough? No. This is not a geographically accurate telling of the tale, but... Yeah. Sorry about that. Just had to adjust a couple things. The adjustments did not work. And that's just the kind of day I'm having today. So, I'm not going to blow against the wind if things aren't going to work out for me today. So be it. I'll wait till tomorrow. But enough things are, so I don't know who I'm talking to. Maybe you. Is that better? Can you see me better? Not that that's a good thing, but I had a friend said he saw the stream and he said, I could see what you were doing because I could see your reflection in the monitor. Now, that leads me to think that it doesn't look like I'm intentionally showing both the DAW screen and there's a camera showing me. So I should probably make it a little more clear. See, in the previous project, it looked different, and I kind of want to change it up for every project that I do visually. But I like things about the last setup, so I kept some, those things, and I changed some other things. Now, can you see that there is a layer? There's a layer of this. Does that look familiar? I filmed that glass with water in it, and then slowed it down and put filters through it and made it opaque. Maybe I'll show it to you. Here it comes. Isn't that cool? I love that. I'm gonna try something different every time. And yeah. Last time I made the album cover out of the visuals that I used on the Twitch thing, on the streams. I don't know if I'll do that this time because it's more of a programmatic piece or album. So I'm looking around at photographs of, you know, like Danish sea cliffs. There's some famous, very dramatic, rocky cliffs by the ocean in Denmark. And I think I might use some of that for this piece anyway. On Bandcamp, you can put art up for individual tracks and the album cover. So I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to do that yet, but I usually work on that, the art side of it, while I'm working on the music. And as the music comes out, I throw it right into the Bandcamp page and see how the album starts to look, and I can arrange the order of the tunes and do the artwork as it's coming out before I publish it. So that's what I intend to do for this too. So it's all a fun project. The fun thing for me is I like to have something to do all the time, but I get bored of some aspects of it. Not enough to get rid of them all the time, but to put aside for a while and come back to. And during those times, if I set aside a piece, I can either go work on another piece, or I can just compile sounds that I want to use, or try to brainstorm up new ideas I'm going to use for it. Or I can leave the music aside completely and just head into the art department and kind of do work on visuals and what I want to do for the album cover. And it's kind of what we were talking about in our music and creativity class at Donso University. And I realized that in the preparing for that course that I'm not too good myself at doing that for my own music. So I think I kind of want to step up the game. I would need to make the cover art more indicative of what the music is. So you should be able to look at the album, and that should filter out some people that are totally not interested in what I have to offer musically. So, but you know, if I was doing heavy metal, you know, I wouldn't put a picture of a, you know, an abstract, you know, angular painting or something. You could, and just kind of blow everyone away when they turn on the music. That might be pretty cool. It might work in your advantage if it's a contrast or something. But I admit that when I'm scanning through Bandcamp and I'm looking at album covers, that's the first thing I see when I'm looking for things. That and, you know, hashtags and genre markings and things like that, categories. But the album cover might make me skip it if I don't like the album art. If I think I know what I'm getting into, and I just don't want to go there. I think everyone does that. But some album covers are so compelling to me, and they attract me so much that I have to listen to it. And so there's something in that, I think. If you're attracted by album covers, I think it's important to pay particular attention to that, because you could be losing people that might have otherwise really enjoyed your music. But if you put a scummy, you know, halfway thought through album cover, like I have done in the past, the album that I think I'm most disappointed, the album cover that I'm most disappointed in is Color, Light, and Sound. I don't even know the name of that, right? I'll show you what I mean. Okay. Hold on a second. Okay, here's the unpublished page for the new album. You can see there is no, you know, the title's there, and the three tracks that I'm working on so far are there. These are kind of working mixes. They won't be the final mixes. I just throw them in. When I'm done, I'm done. I leave them. And that's not the price, probably. But the album, the cover art will go here. Yeah, you know how it works. But I wanted to show you album covers that I thought were unsuccessful for me. Let's go to the discography. Okay, right away, I can see which ones are interesting, which ones are not. I like this one. I think this represents the sounds on it. I like Solace, and I like Ambient Spaces. The ones I did this year, I think are pretty good for me. I'm not a graphic artist. I should probably consult people. This one is the loser right here. I thought this would be a cool album cover, but it's horrible. I can see that now. It's ridiculous. What it is it's a microscope photograph of a crystallized silicon or something like that, or some sort of ice crystal. I think it's a silicon, some sort of silicate crystal. And I grabbed it from someone. Where is it? Okay, crystal. It's crystal microscopy. And it's a non attribution derivative open commons license, Creative Commons licensed image, science thing. So I just messed with the color saturation and stuff and just threw my titles on there. And I look at it now and that's horrible. That's not, it looks really dumb. Especially in thumbnail. Check it out. Yeah. Look, you don't want to click on that, do you? Maybe you do. I don't know. I like this one. I like Charting Oceans. And this one is a photograph of the ceiling of an art exhibit, art gallery that I know. And the piece is written for that art gallery, and I think the music fits what that is, so I'll keep that. Other ones, that's not too good. That's pretty bad. That's all right. But this one is good. I like this one a lot. I would love to have an album cover, like a proper size LP of this. I would hang that on my wall. I think that's pretty cool looking. And it was art done, it's digital art done by my friend Colin Dunn, who is a very gifted artist. And he did this in 2013, and I wanted to use it, and he said I could, so I did. I just think it's a very appealing image. I think it's wonderful. I should probably hit him up again and see if he could do some more art for me, because that one works. And he's got some mad skills. Okay, I kind of got off track, didn't I? But we can get back to it. I think I might have this piece pretty much wrapped up. I'm gonna play it back from the beginning and see if anything catches my ear that needs to be changed. So here we go. Oh, hey, Kay. Really good to see you, man. Thanks for dropping in the chat. I will. I should. I mean, he's teaching art in Toronto right now. And yeah, I don't contact him as much as I should. But I'm sure he's pretty busy, like all teachers are right now. Hi. This is my friend Kay, everyone. Everyone. It's just you and me. Oh, not so. Thank you very much. Did you catch me on my long explanation about album art and how mine sucks. Ah, sí. Yo acuerdo de ti, mi amor. So if you're still here, Kay, this piece is one of three so far, pieces based on kind of mental snapshots I have of places as portrayed in Beowulf. And I don't like any of the movies that I've seen on Beowulf, because they never match up my imagination. What I imagine the places and feelings of those places to be. And these are the Danish sea cliffs to me. Before the heroes arrive, I imagine that watching these sea cliffs from these guard posts on the cold sea cliffs are kind of a bad, lonely, sad job to do. And the guard is the one who kind of meets Beowulf in Denmark for the first time and kind of says, "Well, what are you doing here, all this?" And he convinces him to he convinces the guard that he's not here to fight you. He's here to cleanse the land of the evil terror of Grendel. And so I'm imagining what just the job of the lonely watchman would be like on this kind of often cold during the winters, just lonely, dusty, foreboding, forbidding sea cliffs. Sorry, I have to go back and change something. No doubt. That's pretty much, I think, it for this one. I'll put it away for now, but I'm sure I'll have another listen to it in the future. usually after I finish something, I put it away for a day or two at least, and then come back to it in case my ears have changed about it. Fresh ears to it, and then decide if it's done. That's the test. And if it passes that, then it's done. So I'm going to switch to chat mode. Here we go. Ready for chat mode? Chat mode. And now I can chat with you. Without all the other stuff going on. Cool. So what have you been up to today, Kay? What's your thing today? No, thank you. This is from a album earlier in the year. Go Jay, scouting. Scouting, as in building campfires and with two sticks rubbing together and merit badges and things like that. Oh, okay. I kind of figured that. Oh, that's cool. That's fun. It's been a long time since I've looked at a new gallery. I think it's about time. I look forward to our meeting next week. Did you find any cool galleries today? Two. Yeah, hikes. Oh, you too. Ah, yes. In Goje. Is there a big art scene in Goje? Artisans, ah yes, just like are you looking for them to include in the Liquid Arts project, or the Liquid Arts Arts Network? Cool. Those things are, yeah, it's good to have a lot of those different things on the website. I saw that website, by the way. Oh, it's really cool looking. I think I can share that here. We'll probably talk more about exactly how to do this next week when we meet, but okay, some are hits, some are misses. I get it. Right, that's what you do best, don't you? Connect. Make connections. That's what a network is, right? Yeah, I saw it recently, and it's not up yet. Oh, okay. The version that I saw looked pretty cool. It reminded me of the do you know the are you familiar with WOMAD? Peter Gabriel's kind of pet project that he's had for, geez, pet project from 30 years ago? Yeah. It's the World Organization of Drummers, Musicians and Drummers. The World Organization of Musicians and Drummers, I think. WOMAD. Have you heard of that? They're a similar kind of artists network, but it focuses on musicians, composers. Okay. But yeah, yours was every bit as professional as theirs, with real world studios. But yeah, I loved your thing. Is it all right? Maybe I should wait till we talk about branding and stuff. So, because I can, yeah, we'll talk about this when we meet next week. But I can definitely put banners and things and filter some people. I don't have a lot of followers yet, but it's slowly growing, very slowly. I'm meeting some really cool. Okay, we wait. I'm meeting some really cool composers around the world through this project, because apparently the pandemic has driven a lot of musicians and also composers to Twitch, who have found a kind of window open to composing. And it's not the most interesting, you know, action-packed visual experience, but to people who are interested in it, in the process and things, and it can be pretty fun. And these composers, some of these composers I've met are just amazing. They really work fast, and the stuff that they're doing, it's kind of like watching a sculptor at work, and which is incredible. And I think Twitch is a really good platform for that. And a bunch of us are trying it out, and I'm making friends, and we support each other, and we learn from each other, and we swap tales and talk about gear and software and techniques and people we like, composers, and it's just fun. And it's really cool people. This one guy in Scotland, guy in England, and this guy in the US. Yeah, it's fun. We should get them on the network. But some of them have their own companies that they are handled by, but I'd love to be handled by I'd love to be handled by you, Kay. No, don't quote me on that. By the Liquid Arts Network. That podcast is really awesome. The format, it sounds great. Gino's the man for hosting stuff like that. I can't wait for the next installment. CC's was great. Oh, is she still in town? I remember her. Is this the same person I'm thinking of? Or is Shane your girlfriend? I'm outing you on... You're not going to respond to that, are you? Oh. Okay. Okay. Your web manager, your website manager. Yeah, I'll do what you need me to do, and nice. I'm excited. I think this is a really fantastic idea you've got with the whole Liquid Arts Network. Obviously, I've got a lot to learn about it, how it works, and I've never really been good at marketing myself or putting myself out there. Just never was something I was good at or tried to be good at. Yeah. Somehow, we'll work it out. At the very least, I'm glad you stopped by. Oh yeah, I'm starting to become interested in Instagram. I'm really a noob at it, but Instagram. Yeah, I like the look, just the feel of it, and how artist friendly it is, or it seems to be. And all my favorite people are on there. Okay, I think I'm gonna wrap it up. And I don't know how many times we can listen to this large window piece before it gets stale. So I'm going to sign off for this time. And all right, head out into the night. Yeah, it's kind of a Friday for me too. So it's Thursday, but it's a TGIT. Thank goodness it's Thursday. Yeah, good night to you. Thanks for coming by, Kay. And to anyone else viewing, whoever you are, I can see there are three of you, including Kay. Kay is Busan Groundfish. All right. Oh, it's you two. she's in the next room. Busan Misan. All right. Take care, everyone, and we'll see you next time. Bonne nuit. Bonne nuit. And till next time. Hasta mañana. See you. 나중에 보자. Ciao.